covered with shipping, a sight hardly to be matched in the whole world.
Even after the waste and ruin of the last war, the first editorial of a new journal proclaimed, "The importance of Hong Kong transcends the mere financial and commercial sphere. It is an international meeting place of the first order, a civilization exchange between West and East."
香港最后一位港督认为香港备受福荫，成为平等就业体制的成功典范。我们现在有请港督致告别词。 The last British governor has said that he finds Hong Kong today a blazing beacon of good fortune, a dazzling example of what free men and women, putting adversity and hardship behind them, can together achieve. We now invite him to make his farewell to the city that he has served.
Your Royal Highness, Prime Minister, distinguished guests, people of Hong Kong. For Hong Kong as a whole, today is cause for celebration, not sorrow. But here and there, perhaps there will be a touch of personal sadness, as is true of any departure, a point to which I shall return. History is not just a matter of dates. What makes history is what comes before and what comes after the dates that we all remember. The story of this great city is about the years before this night, and the years of success that will surely follow it. Of course, Hong Kong's story is not solely that of the century and a half of British responsibility, though it is the conclusion of that chapter that we mark tonight. This chapter began with events that, from today's vantage point, at the end of the following century, none of us here would wish or seek to condone. But we might note that most of those who live in Hong Kong now do so because of events in our own century which would today have few defenders. All that is a reminder that sometimes we should remember the past, the better to forget it. What we celebrate this evening is the restless energy, the hard work, the audacity of the men and women who have written Hong Kong's success story, mostly Chinese men and Chinese women. They were only ordinary in the sense that most of them came here with nothing. They are extraordinary in what they have achieved against the odds. As British administration ends, we are, I believe, entitled to say that our own nation's contribution here was to provide the scaffolding that enabled the people of Hong Kong to ascend. The rule of law, clean and light-handed government, the values of a free society, the beginnings of representative government and democratic accountability. This is a Chinese city, a very Chinese city with British characteristics. No dependent territory has been left more prosperous. none with such a rich texture and fabric of civil society. Professions, churches, newspapers, charities, civil servants of the highest probity and the most steadfast commitment to the public good. I have no doubt that with people here holding on to these values which they cherish, Hong Kong's star will continue to climb. Hong Kong's values are decent values. They are universal values. They are the values of the future in Asia as elsewhere. A future in which the happiest and the richest communities, and the most confident and most stable too, will be those that best combine political liberty and economic freedom as we do here today. All of us here tonight, and I am sure all my fellow countrymen and women watching these events from afar, wish the Chief Executive of the Special Administrative Region and his excellent team the very best of luck as they embark on their journey. C.H. Tung and his wife Betty will serve Hong Kong with dedication, strength, and enthusiasm. Everyone here, and people outside Hong Kong as well, will be willing them to succeed in the challenging years that lie ahead. I said that tonight's celebration will be tinged for some with sadness. So it will be for my family and myself, and for others who, like us, will soon depart from this shore. I am the 28th governor, the last governor. Like all the other governors and their families, my wife, my children, and myself will take Hong Kong home in our hearts. You have been kind to us. You have made us welcome. It has been the greatest honor and privilege of my life to share your home for 5 years and to have some responsibility for your future. Now, Hong Kong people are to run Hong Kong. That is the promise, and that is the unshakable destiny.
in its myriad sounds is part of life in Hong Kong. More often than the stately music of Elgar are heard the drums of dragon boats and the clangor of lion dances.
But the double, double, double beat of the thundering drum may also mark a passing band, passing on parade, exhorting us all to lift our heads, walk in step, and raise our spirits.
March bands, by the center, quick march!
gentlemen, His Royal Highness, the Prince of Wales.
Governor, Prime Minister, ladies and gentlemen, I have been asked by Her Majesty the Queen to read the following message. 5 hours from now, the Union flag will be lowered and the flag of China will fly over Hong Kong. More than a century and a half of British administration will come to an end. During that time, Hong Kong has grown from a small coastal settlement into one of the leading cities and one of the greatest trading economies in the world. There have been times of sacrifice, suffering, and courage. As Hong Kong has risen from the ashes of war, a most dramatic transformation has taken place. Millions of destitute immigrants have been absorbed, and Hong Kong has created one of the most successful societies on earth. Britain is both proud and privileged to have been involved with this success story. Proud of the British values and institutions that have been the framework for Hong Kong's success. Proud of the rights and freedoms which Hong Kong people enjoy. Privileged to have been associated with the prodigiously talented and resourceful people of Hong Kong who have built upon that foundation. The British flag will be lowered and British administrative responsibility will end. But Britain is not saying goodbye to Hong Kong. More than 3.5 million Hong Kong residents are British nationals. Thousands of young Hong Kong men and women study in Britain every year. We share language and the English common law. And thousands of Britons, too, have made their homes in Hong Kong. The shared legacy of family and of friendship, trade and investment, culture and history run strong and deep. Britain is part of Hong Kong's history, and Hong Kong is part of Britain's history. We are also part of each other's future. We are confident that the ties between us will not only endure, but will continue to develop. In a shrinking world, Hong Kong's role as Europe's gateway to Asia and Britain's role as Asia's gateway to Europe will reinforce the bonds between our two societies. For all these reasons, my government and I will continue to take the closest interest in Hong Kong and in its development. The British Consulate General, which will be inaugurated in a few hours' time, will be our largest in the world. The Sino-British Joint Liaison Group will continue for another 2.5 years to discuss matters concerning the implementation of the Sino-British Joint Declaration. That joint declaration itself remains in force for 50 years. For many years to come, the Hong Kong connection will command our attention. Hong Kong now faces its transition to Chinese sovereignty in excellent condition, prosperous, stable, and dynamic. Unprecedented though this moment in history may be, we have the utmost confidence in the abilities and resilience of the Hong Kong people. Britain learnt long ago that Hong Kong people know best what is good for Hong Kong. We have no doubt that Hong Kong people can run Hong Kong, as the Joint Declaration promises, and that faithful implementation of the Joint Declaration is the key to Hong Kong's continued success. The eyes of the world are on Hong Kong today. I wish you all a successful transition and a prosperous and peaceful future.
you got? Roll light! Press!
Dead! Ah! All right! Well, advance!
sun sets, the order of the world changes, but the light of friendship and the warmth of memory remain.
Britain has been honored to have been part of the history of Hong Kong and to have shared in building the great free city that we see around us.
Hong Kong has been happy in our partnership. The past holds sorrows and yet has been full of joys. We will remember and be glad. We will remain as friends.
Time moves on, but the strength of our affection will not change. And we know that with the courage that brought success in the past, with the confidence that success has earned, everything, everything is possible.
时光流逝，世事不断转变。 但係有如浩瀚碧波，巍巍大山。過去嘅友誼經得起考驗，未來嘅友誼今日邁出第一步。This
city, this city has a sure foundation. The years turn, our lives change, but there is something as firm as the mountains, as ceaseless as the seas. The friendship that endures. The friendship of the future, now begun.